Welcome to Cyan Orange Academy, where you will learn with us about digital and traditional art. In this episode, we're going to talk about Photoshop's interface and how to organize it to have the best working space for artists. Photoshop comes with predetermined workspaces with names that suggest the field or discipline they are best for. We are digital 2D artists, so we're going to base our workspace from the one named Painting. In order to better understand the interface and our working space, let's divide the screen into three zones. Let's first talk about the Tools zone. The brushes are one of the most important painting tools in Photoshop. That is why it is very important to have them very visible in your working space. We recommend just having the brushes you need. Too many can be overwhelming at times. Also, give them names. This will help you organize and easily remember each of your brushes when you need them. The second window you should have in this zone is Brush Settings. Remember that in this window, you can alter the properties of your brushes. For example, with color dynamics, you can avoid flat and monotone colors in your painting. We recommend you explore and experiment with these properties. Now let's talk about the zone in the middle, the one we call the canvas zone. This is the zone that has to occupy the most amount of space in Photoshop. You will also find the rulers in this zone, a very useful tool in Photoshop. You can manipulate two rulers, one vertical and one horizontal. The rulers can be activated with Ctrl-R and deactivated with the same command. The rulers can also generate guides that are by default light blue. The guides will never alter the drawing and you can create as many as you like. You can activate and deactivate with the shortcut H. At the bottom left corner of this area, you will find the zoom and approximate size and bits indicators. Now let's talk about the final zone, the color and layer area. Let's start with the color section. The color window is a must-have in this zone. You will be able to alter the color and properties here and visualize the different color modes in Photoshop. Let's talk about the best way to organize this window for digital artists like us. As you can see, you will find two main controllers to alter, several bars you can move from left to right and vice versa, and a square spectrum of color, where you'll be able to see the color directly. Many of you must be wondering now, well, what are these bars and the spectrum? Well, the bars alter the numerical configuration of colors and allow us to alter each property individually, such as hue, saturation, and value. On the other hand, the spectrum of color is a display of the color spectrum that allows us to select a color with just a click. Beginners can easily get confused and lost with the many abbreviations you will find in this window, but relax. Let us explain what each one means. HSB means hue, saturation, and brightness. RGB means red, green, and blue. On the other hand, CMYK means cyan, magenta, yellow, and key. We will cover in our color video the differences of these color modes. Let's move on to the next window you will find in the color section, swatches. In this window, we can keep a controlled palette that can be created by us, very similar to how traditional painters work. Some of you must be wondering, why when we work, our color section looks so different from the standard one in Photoshop? That is because we have installed an extra plugin called Colorus. We highly recommend this plugin for advanced artists interested in a better color working space. Now let's move on to the Layers window. As its name implies, here you can control the numerous layers in your file. This property is truly one that sets digital and traditional art apart. In digital art, you can very comfortably control your process setting up different layers. The sketch in one layer, the flat color in another layer, and finally, the painted version in a different layer. If we keep a clear and organized space, keeping in mind the three zones, we guarantee your working time will be highly optimized, not losing precious time trying to find the right tools to get the job done. Thanks again to those who sent their homework. The one shown here is our favorite. For this video's homework, we invite you to use the working space we talked about in the video to draw anything you'd like and send it to us. In our next video, we will give you an introduction to color, which will conclude our series in How to Draw in Digital Art. See you guys in the next one!